G-A-C-H-E, gouache. Once you learn to say it, you start to feel posh. It's got that matte finish that makes you say gosh. I display it to my friends with style and panache.
Gosh, it's my gouache. Gosh, it's my gouache. Gosh, it's my gouache. Gosh, it's my gouache.
Okay, but can you tell me what the finish on it's like when it dries? And how does that compare to acrylic?
Gouache and acrylic paints have a similar look and feel when you're painting with them, but there are a number of differences between these two paints. One of the differences is that when it dries, gouache has a matte finish, and acrylic has a glossy finish to it. This means that gouache absorbs light and acrylic reflects it. So depending on your lighting setup, it can be easier to photograph a gouache painting, easier than photographing acrylic.
G-O-U-A-C-H-E, gouache. My art is like a wave, I move with the slosh. When these critics try to hurt me, their comments I squash. Cause my work is divine, but needs salt just to dosh.
Gosh, it's my gouache. Gosh, it's my gouache. Gosh, it's my gouache. Gosh, it's my gouache.
All right, anything else I should know about what happens when it dries? What about when acrylic dries?
Gouache and acrylic paint look and feel very similar when you're using them straight out of the tube, but when they dry, they do act differently. Acrylic paint dries and is waterproof, and that means you can go over it with other paint and not reactivate it. No green paint was picked up on this brush. Gouache is different. It is reactivated by water, so that means if you're trying to go over it, paint the same way you would with acrylic, you'll reactivate the underneath paint. Here, we've picked up that green undertone. So the two paints, they do need to be approached differently.